Okay, what we want to do now is remove the caliper and inspect the brake pads, but before you remove the caliper, what we like to do is clamp off the brake line with the appropriate tool. And the reason we're doing that is when you push that caliper piston back, you don't want to push that dirty fluid back up to the master cylinder going through the ABS unit. So we'll clamp off the hose with the appropriate tool, open up the bleeder, and we'll push that piston back, catching the dirty fluid in an appropriate container. Once you've got the piston collapsed all the way, close the bleeder so you don't draw in any air when you release the clamp, and there won't be a need to bleed it afterwards. And before you remove that caliper, be sure not to let it hang by the hose. You'd be surprised how many shops where you go into and you see this hanging. If you let it hang by the hose, it will distort the brake hose and damage the hose. So appropriate clamp, hold the caliper up and out of the way. Next thing we want to do is remove the pads and inspect the pads. And this particular pad, as I pointed out before, is a little bit stubborn to come out because of the shim contacting the caliper area. Next thing you want to do is look at the pads, and you want to read the pads for thickness. You want to make sure that the pads are wearing equal between inboard and outboard, or if there's taper wear. Okay, we've already removed the brake pads. The next step would be removing the caliper bracket and remove the rotor.